Hey everybody, Kratos Lucina here, and today we're taking out the Fox. This is the FV 721, a replacement for the FV 701 Ferret, developed in the late 60s, not a like 65 to 69, I think, not adopted until 73. By the UK. Mint is just a, in this game it's classified as APC, but it's more of an armored reconnaissance car. And, has a the 30 millimeter gun on it with the two missile launchers on top. And it saw service up until the I think the 90s. It was a very long service life for this particular vehicle. And it was taken out of service during the UK's demilitarization agreements it made with some other countries. And along with that demilitarization, the Scorpions were taken out of service. And what that did is that generated a lot of vehicles with nothing to do. At which point, the turrets were removed, plate removed from this, placed on top of the. What's happening with my? There we go. Placed on top of the. Placed on top of the Scorpion chassis, and then. Oh, fine. I'll go fight some helicopters. Placed on top of the Scorpion chassis, and that resulted in the Sabre that I've driven before. Now this little I mean it really is more armored car than like APC or AFV, but this allows it to be extremely fast. Whoa. See, that would have destroyed most vehicles. Can you not? And it made for a very effective scout vehicle. I think there are a couple countries that are still using it kind of here and there, but to no grandiose effect. But as far as the UK is concerned, it is a dead vehicle now. Let's hope I don't find any trouble on my way out to shoot this helicopter. See how close I can get to it. And it's a zippy little thing. I mean, like, the Saber on its own is already a zippy little thing, but I mean, this thing just took it to a whole new level. Don't see me. Yeah, this tiny little thing, it's good at facilitating the fight. I wouldn't really want to judge it to be the peak of the fight. Hey, finally got a kill. Why do we. What's the fight here? Whoa, that was close. It does have a kind of a phenomenal view range on it, but in a way, it is kind of let down by the fact that it's basically made of cheese. And any enemy that is baseline or superior is going to spot you. It's not that they might spot you, it's that they will spot you. And there's nothing you can do to stop it. The missiles are very effective. Killing whatever tank was the trigger tank was someone hit the trigger tank and that saved my life because I'm pretty sure I was literally an eighth of a second from exploding. And I think killing whatever the trigger tank was saved me. So this was a fairly fast mission, but I did get to exhibit, show off its ability to move around the battlefield quickly. And it's very good at doing that test. Now, doing those humongous ramps off of high cliffs and stuff, probably not ideal for this particular vehicle. But Armored Warfare is Armored Warfare. But it is a very agile vehicle for being a big armored car. It can zip around the battlefield quickly, get things done, send missiles, collect information, move that information along to friendlies. And oh look, I got combat experience. It's a good scout. This would definitely work better on a more open map. One with, longer sight lines where you can kind of sneak around and get good views on bad guys. It would function better in that role other than this mission where it's a lot of real close infighting. But even here, it still held its own, and I never died. I got really close at the end, but I never died, so I consider that a good note for this thing. Anyway, if you enjoyed that mission, please like and subscribe. Comment down below if you'd love to see a tank in battle, and I will see you guys in the next mission. Until then, have fun!